The Navy went out to Utah recently along with the Army and its contractor team of Lockheed Martin and Northrop Grumman, and for the hypersonic weapon that both services plan to field in the coming years, basically took the solid rocket motor that they intend to use, and they did a live fire event for the first time. So they turned the rocket motor on, they let it run for as long as it needed to, they gathered a bunch of data about the rocket motor performance, and basically they report that it met all the metrics it needed to for the time being, and it was a successful first run for the rocket motor. So the hypersonic weapon is basically a long-range, very fast, greater than Mach 5, greater than 5 times the speed of sound weapon. Basically, should be able to hit anywhere in the globe within, you know, minutes, less than an hour. And it's a deterrent that would be, you know, rather than only having a nuclear weapon that can strike at that speed and that range, this would be a non-nuclear option for that. So obviously it would take a very powerful motor to fire such a large and such a fast weapon. So the military has already tested the glide body, which is the actual form the missile will take place in. However, this is the first time they've had the chance to work on the motor, which will power it. This is a Northrop Grumman developed rocket motor, which is integrated into the whole system by Lockheed Martin. This is the very first live test they've done. There'll have to be a series of upcoming tests to test the rocket motor in increasingly difficult circumstances, and eventually they'll get to the point where they can integrate it into the glide body and do a full system test. Now the Army is looking to have this ready to go and start integrating with their ground launchers by 2023. So the rocket motor development will all start happening in very rapid succession to lead up to that date. The Navy will take a little bit longer to integrate the full system with its launchers. They'll be launching it from both surface ships and submarines, which takes a little bit longer to engineer. So they're looking at a 2025 date. But really between now and 2023, it'll just be a rapid succession of rocket motor tests, combining that into the glide body and doing full system testing. The Navy particularly has its eye on two mission sets for this hypersonic missile. It'll be called the conventional prompt strike missile for the Navy side, which is to say that it's a conventional option to use instead of a nuclear missile. It's supposed to provide the same level of deterrent in that the Navy would have these fielded on its Zumwalt class destroyers, and it would have the missile fielded on its guided missile submarines, which are basically lurking anywhere in the ocean. They could be anywhere in the globe. So that sort of stealth nature of the submarines combined with the high speed and the long range of these missiles means that the Navy would be able to hit any target at any time, and really is meant to discourage any adversary from taking drastic actions against the United States. So the Navy is looking to integrate the same missile with both the surface ships and the submarines. They have sort of an idea of this all-up tube. There's a canister that would hold it and would integrate with a launcher both on the submarine, which would launch underwater, come up out of the water, and go through the air as normal. The same launcher would also go on the Zumwalt class destroyers for the time being, and possibly look to integrate onto other ships as well. The Army, for its part, is on a little bit of a quicker timeline. By 2023, they're looking to have the hypersonic missile, which they're calling a long-range hypersonic weapon, and that will take the common glide body and rocket motor and integrate the weapon into a ground launcher, which they'd then be able to use from various locations around the globe. Rather than the Navy at sea kind of having a mobile version of this hypersonic weapon, the Army would have a fixed ground-based version of it. So with this recent rocket motor test, the Navy, Army, and industry team will look to continue pushing the limits of the rocket motor, better understand it, and begin to integrate it with the rest of the glide body of the weapon. From there, the Army's on a pretty quick path to field the weapon in 2023. There's already images of soldiers working with the canisters, kind of practicing working with a weapon of the magnitude of this, very large containers to have to haul around. So the Army's already getting a head start on just learning to operate around a weapon of this size. The Navy is looking at a 2025 date to field on the Zumwalt class destroyers, and the submarines will be a little bit later date down the road, but the Zumwalt class destroyer is the priority for the Navy. What we saw last week is the next step in what is one of the Navy and Army's top priorities right now, which is to achieve a hypersonic weapon that can be shot from the ground and from Navy ships and submarines. In budget submissions, this has consistently been a top priority. It's receiving top priority funding because it's so important to the way they want to operate in the future against high-end adversaries, possibly against across very long distances. And so this rocket motor test really gets them on the path to integrating the complete system and having it fielded with the Army within the next 2 years. And we'll be covering future developments as they happen.